Oh, look. What is this? What is this?
It's Harry Potter.
Harry Potter? Look at that. Oh my god. It's Harry Potter, the Prisoner of Azkaban.
I'm taking a class on this, so I have to read 6 more chapters by Friday. Hey guys, it's Alyssa, and welcome to Alyssa Explains It All. So, the acceptance student page of the class of 2019, which is incoming freshmen and transfers that are coming next year, have been active. I mean, a lot of people are on there now. But one of the many questions that I get, and I've been getting this for the past 3 years that I've been doing this, is what dorm should I live in? And you know what? I'm going to try to summarize that question in this video, because this video is about dorms. Resident halls, the places where you will probably live if you attend SUNY Oswego. I hope this video helps you get to that preference, and I hope that whatever dorm you do end up living in is the dorm that you will like for that year, maybe that semester. I don't know what your plans are. So there's a lot of different options for living arrangements on campus and off campus, but freshmen are not allowed to live off campus, so that's out of the question. Places where freshmen can't live are Onondaga, which is where I live right now. It's suites. Usually upperclassmen usually live here. So if you are a transfer, there is a chance that you could live here, but freshmen, out, bye. There's also the Village, which is now open to sophomores, juniors, and seniors. If you are a freshman, I'm sorry you can't live there, but it's a great place. I really want to live there. So it's a great place for you to consider in the future. But right now, let's concentrate on you right now, because you right now is the present and we need to worry about you right now. So let's talk about places that you can live as a freshman. There are different places on campus. Now I'm gonna try to like not tell you everything about every single hall, but I'm gonna help you decide what hall is the hall for you. Let's start off where I am right now. I'm on West Campus. It's not the prettiest side of the campus, but it is part of the campus and it's pretty cool. I like it here. I've been here for 2 years. I lived in Seneca, currently live in Onondaga, or as we call it here, Daga. I mean, that's some slang that you kind of need to know. There's also Cayuga and Oneida. Seneca is a very tall building. It has 10 floors, so there's a lot of people living there. I think it's noted as the largest living area where all the people live. There's a lot of people living in there. Cayuga and Oneida are 4 floors, but they're really big this way, not this way. Cayuga and Seneca are part of Pathfinder Dining Hall. You're connected by tunnels, and Onondaga and Oneida are connected to Little Page Dining Hall by tunnels. There's Glimmerglass Gym, which is in Onondaga's basement, so that's really nice and convenient for you. It's right by the lagoon. The lagoon's really nice. Kind of iced right now, but it's still really pretty. The West Campus is probably really, it looks really old compared to the rest of the campus because it hasn't been renovated in a really, really long time, but I still think it's really nice here. It's pretty roomy here. The heat is really hot, but that's okay. It's okay. Every hall is co-ed though. I just would like to point that out. That's also a very important aspect. All halls are co-ed. Sometimes you will have a opposite sex living next to you, but sometimes sometimes it's just like strip of girls, strip of guys, strip of girls, strip of guys, or it can be like one whole side of the floor is girls and the other whole side is guys. You didn't hear this from me, but West Campus is known to be the party side of campus. Not saying that any other part of the school is not party side, but because it's a large part of the campus that a lot of people live on, a lot of party people live here. Please drink responsibly and remember to stay safe if you are gonna go out and party, but remember not to always party. You can't always be doing that. You gotta do other things too. This is college. Study. Let's move on to the next part of campus, which is Central Campus, which is Fennell and Hart, which are connected to Cooper Dining Hall, which also has Cooper Gym down there too. So you got 2 gyms on campus. You got one on West Campus and one on Central Campus. Fennell is really nice. It's tall. It has a lot of people living there. I mean, if I didn't live anywhere else, I would probably pick Fennell. Hart is the international hall on campus, so a majority of people who do live there are students from other countries. And that's a cool experience in itself. You get a credit for living there and you have to do like a lot of community service, but you know what, it's a really nice experience if you're into that kind of thing. And if you are international, this is probably where you'll be living your first semester living there. And I think Central Campus is a great place to live because it is in the middle. So like if you have to walk this way or this way or this way, like you're right in the middle, so you don't have to walk that far compared to other people.
everywhere else.
Lakeside area, which is pretty much a strip on the lake when you first come through the school this way, you have Scales, Waterbury, Riggs, and Johnson Hall. Scales and Waterbury are gonna probably be renovated. Waterbury is currently being renovated right now and supposedly going to open in the fall. So for those of you guys, you're probably gonna live in the new Waterbury, and then they're gonna probably close Scales to be renovated. They are not connected to any dining halls, so if you're gonna have to go eat, you're gonna have to leave the building, which is kind of sad, but it's a nice place. It has really big rooms. It's nice and cozy in there. You can meet a lot of people. There's still a lot of people living there. And it's right on the lake, so if you ever need to go down to the lake, you can just leave right there. Riggs is connected to Johnson through a kind of a tunnel. So Riggs is really nice. Riggs is compared to Johnson as like the Johnson Hall that doesn't have all freshmen. So you still have like luxuries of kind of like living in Johnson, but you're in Riggs and you're also on the lake, so that's also really cool. And you're connected to the dining hall, so you don't have to leave. Johnson Hall, I already made a video on because Johnson Hall is the all freshman dorm on campus. So I made a totally separate video for that explaining all what Johnson Hall offers. So if you can, I'm not gonna really explain about it, but you should click here to go straight to that video because that has all the information on that right there. Then there's East Campus area, which a lot of people forget about. There's like the Mackin Complex area, which has Lonis and, God damn it. Hold on.
Sarah,
yeah.
What's in the
Mackin
Complex, Lonis?
Yeah.
Okay, what is Mackin a building?
And we're back. I've done my research. East Campus is mostly the Mackin Complex, as they call it, and it has Lonis and Moreland. Now, Lonis is known to have singles, so a majority of freshmen probably won't be put there, just saying. And there's Moreland, which recently is doubles and things like that, but recently has been triples because we've had a lot of freshmen come this year and they had to make triples because a lot of freshmen are here and we gotta put them somewhere. But if you're currently living there, I'm proud of you. You are doing so well. Good for you. You deserve a cookie. There's no actual dining hall, like dining hall that you can swipe your ID with, what part of the meal plan. There's Mackin, which is kind of like a grill, fried food kind of thing. I'm not gonna really talk about it, but Sheldon Hall, I mean, it's not an option for anybody. I mean, graduate students mostly live there. So if you ever meet anybody ever who says that they're living in Sheldon, it's because they're a grad student. So I hope that cleared some things up. I mean, there's so many more things I can go into, like how are the bathrooms, size of rooms, air conditioning, people living there. Not really that. But if you ever have any questions about specific things about the dorms, just hit me up, because I will try to answer as much as I can. I've only lived in Waterbury, Seneca, Johnson, and Onondaga, so I can't really answer a lot of questions about all the other halls because I haven't experienced them as myself, but I can probably ask people who have lived there, if anything. I'm just here to help you. So don't ask me what hall should I live in, ask me about specifics and I will try to research and help you out from there. You're awesome, I'm awesome, and thank you for watching this video. And if you want, you can hit that subscribe button to find out when I post more Alyssa Explains It All. If you have any questions or video ideas or any comments about anything, again, hit me up. You can tweet me at Alyssa15 or you can Facebook message me or anything. All right, see you guys around. Ha! No, I gotta read Harry Potter. It's annoying. I just said that. It's annoying to read Harry Potter for class. This is like researching stuff. It's really hard to finish one Harry Potter book in 2 weeks. I have other things to do. It's really exhausting.